On the morning of May 28th, I would head to the Tennessee Valley Railroad Museum in Chattanooga, Tennessee. My first train would be loaded grain train in S46R with a GE trio leading. Later that morning, Southern 4501 would make her appearance leading TVRM Train 100, the Missionary Ridge Local. It had been 8 years since I last saw an operational steam locomotive, so I felt like a kid in a candy store seeing the 4501 pulling into the station at Grand Junction. After picking up passengers at Grand Junction, the 4501 would reverse the train up the Y and begin its first excursion of the day towards East Chattanooga. Thank you. After TVRM 100 departed, NS-223 would pass the museum and roll through Control Point, Jersey. Not long after NS-223 passed, TVRM 100 would return to Grand Junction to allow passengers to detrain and board for the second excursion of the day.
We'll do a regular stop unless we see some ramp activity down here.
The train would then pull forward to allow a handicapped passenger to board. The 4501 would put on a show with the cylinder cocks open on a slight uphill grade. After all the passengers had boarded, the train would reverse up the Y and head for East Chattanooga. Thank you. The Missionary Ridge Local runs 5 times a day, allowing for plenty of opportunities to photograph the train. The next train on Norfolk Southern would be NS-265, with a pair of BNSF ES-44s leading. After catching NS-265, I would head over to the Chickamauga Creek Bridge to catch the 4501 once again. I would catch TVRM 100 leaving for the third excursion of the day as it passed Tennessee, Alabama, and Georgia number 80, which was on the point of the dinner train consist. I would elect to ride the fourth excursion of the day. First, we see the classic turntable demonstration, where they turn the 4501 around for the return trip. Note that the 4501 is 5 feet longer than the turntable, so be sure to keep your distance. Conductor Zach Langley would give commentary on the demonstration while the 4501 was being turned. Also, take note of the crewman that gets off of the 4501 as the engine is being turned.
It was built in 1911 by the Baldwin Locomotive Works in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, as a mainline freight locomotive for the Southern Railway. It was used by the Southern Railway well into the 1940s, when it was sold to the Kentucky and Tennessee Railway in Stern, Tennessee, where it was being used to help pull down for the mine. It was acquired by one of our co-founders here at the museum in the early 60s, Paul Merriam, and so he went out there and purchased a locomotive for $5,000 to his own cash, brought it down to Chattanooga, and we've been using it here both at the museum and on mainline excursions on and off ever since. This locomotive is a 282, meaning it has two small pilot wheels in the front, eight large driving wheels in the middle, and two trailing wheels under the cabin firebox. This is the very first 282 ever purchased by the Southern Railway. Hundreds of these they would eventually purchase, and ironically, also the only Southern Railway 282 that's still brought today. So it was the first, and now it's the last. This locomotive operates at 205 PSI, but a 63-inch diameter driving wheel, and it produces 53,900 pounds of track and pepper. For track number two. If you'd like to see the back shop, you can follow me. We're just getting headed into this large building in the distance. If you don't want to see the back shop, you can feel free to reboard the train at any time.
Next, we would walk by some of the TVRM's other equipment, including Southern 630, Southern 5000, Southern 6914, and TVRM 610. Once we were finished with the shop tour, we would board the local again and head back to Grand Junction. I would see more interesting equipment on the return trip, including Southern 3170 and two antique diesels with Lehigh Valley Railroad heritage. A couple other words of warning: if you elect to ride in the cab of the engine, or in any of the open-air cars, you will be exposed to smoke and cinders. Also, if you plan to film outside the cars, hold on to your camera for dear life. With that said, enjoy the remaining images and the footage of the return trip to Grand Junction.
Okay.
Not long after I detrained, NS-127 would knock down Control Point Jersey. I was not able to set my tripods up in time, but I was able to capture this moment of past meeting present, which is what makes the Tennessee Valley Railroad Museum so unique. I would then catch the 4501 leading the final excursion of the day out of Grand Junction. With it being Memorial Day weekend, I thought it would be appropriate to get a shot of 4501 passing the American flag at half mast. Soon after the 4501 departed, the dinner train crew would run tag 80 around the Y to get it in position to lead the dinner train. I would catch it from inside Grand Junction Depot and then go outside to get it at the crossing. NS-188 would come next. I was not in a good position for it, so this was the best I could do. NS-4038, NS-4461. NS-373 would come after NS-188 with another Union Pacific leader. The 4501 would then arrive at Grand Junction to bring the last excursion of the day to an end. After all of the passengers detrained, the 4501 would shove TVRM 100 back to East Chattanooga, where the crew would call it a day. Soon after the departure of the 4501, NS-143 would pass the museum with a trio of Union Pacific units, with SD-70 Ace UP-8565 leading the way. 8:43 passed, the dinner train crew would back their train into Grand Junction Station to prepare for that evening's ride. I considered leaving after getting the dinner train backing in, but it is a good thing I stayed because NS Local AC-10 would pose beside Tag 80 and then pull forward before making a shove move. Note that the second engine on AC-10 is freshly rebuilt SD-40-3 NS-6409. I was not able to find any pictures of this engine on the internet, so I have reason to believe I am the first person to get a picture of this engine. While talking with Travis Gordon, who was the engineer for the dinner train that day, NS-189 would appear with a 1x1 lash-up of NS-Jeebos. As 6:30 p.m. came, TVRM 225 would depart Grand Junction with Engineer Gordon at the throttle. It was a very hot day that day, so I decided to head to Cahutta, Georgia for some ice cream. NS-215 would come through Cahutta as the last bit of light lingered in the sky. My last train of the day would be an all EMD lashup on NS-229. SD-70 IAC NS-1220 and SD-70 ACE NS-1132 would lead the train through Dalton, Georgia past the old freight depot. So with that said, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you haven't already, please like this video and subscribe to my channel because this gives me the motivation to continue making content like this. Thank you for watching. Till next time.